These are nothing but a greasy, nasty mess. Well, hello, beautiful people. Welcome back. So for today's video, we are going to be talking about makeup fails. Makeup I have tried, I have tested, and for whatever reason, it just doesn't work for me. Of course, this is just my experience with these products. It is not necessarily yours. If you love them, if they are your holy grail, please continue to use them, continue to love them. But just for whatever reason, just know that they didn't work for me, but it's okay if they work for you. Everyone's allowed to have their own opinion, their own likes, their own dislikes. I just like to put that out there like every other creator at the beginning of the video, just so you know, like you're not wrong for loving what you love, but I'm also not wrong for absolutely hating it for one reason or another. But anyways, if you're interested in seeing the products that did not work out for me, please stay tuned. We're gonna be jumping into it here in just a second. But before I get that far, I like to pause and briefly introduce myself. My name is Paige. This is Seeking Alexandria. If you are new here, I do upload 3 new videos a week, Monday, Wednesday, Friday. They usually go up around 7:30-ish a.m. my time here in good old Northern Michigan. Then of course, any of you that have not heard me screaming, and I mean literally screaming, okay, from the rooftop, from the mountaintops of Northern Michigan, I would greatly appreciate it if you would go down into the description box and follow me over on Instagram. I'm trying to get to 10,000 followers. That way I can get the swipe up feature in my Insta stories. Would really just make that part of my Instagram life a lot easier to be able to link for you guys, you know, earrings and shirts and shoes and pants and videos and just all of the things that we're already talking about. Even when I'm doing an unboxing, you know, to be able to link that kind of stuff would be super helpful. And then also on Instagram, I love to post like just in my feed. I love to do makeup, makeup looks, makeup IGTVs. So if you're looking for, you know, more of that kind of content, but I also really like plus size fashion on kind of a day-to-day casual, business casual kind of vibe. So if any of that sounds good to you and you would love to check me out over on Instagram, again, I would greatly, greatly appreciate it. Everything will be linked down below. And from there, I think that that's everything. Let's go ahead and get the products. Ooh, I'm so excited. And actually just pause really quick. One more thing to mention. If you missed it, it should be live already, but I'm currently filming a first impression and a wear test on the new NARS Soft Matte Complete Foundation. And like I said, it should be up. So I'll link it up here. But I'm not gonna be getting into the, you know, the makeup that I'm wearing like on my face right now in this video, but everything will be linked down below if you wanna check it out, just if you're curious. I'm down there and I have everything linked. I'm also gonna put the shirt and all of this jewelry. I'm actually kind of proud of myself because I have this tie-dye shirt, which I'm obsessed with. I got it from, I think it's called Mod Boutique online. And when I was wearing this, I was like, oh my God, like I need to live my best multicolor fantasy. And so I went through and I paired all of my Melinda Maria pieces that had like that same multicolor vibe. But anyways, like I said, everything will be linked down below. I'm just so obsessed with how all of the little color coordinated pieces came together. Let's go ahead and get into the first item here. And I'm actually gonna go ahead and start off with Honest Beauty and just kind of clump the brands together. And starting off with them, I have their CC Clean Corrective Tinted Moisturizer. And you guys, I absolutely hate this stuff so much. I have tried to use it so many times, mixing it in with different foundations, concealers, primers, the whole bit, like doing anything that I could do to make it work. And ultimately in the end, like if I have to sum it up, this does not sit well on my skin. It always looks very thick, very heavy, very cakey. This one really bummed me out because one of my favorite hacks, especially for the summer, is to take a tinted cream and like if I'm having, you know, any sort of a breakout, redness, like that sort of thing at all, I love to add in just a couple drops of my Catrice to adjust the coverage. So tinted moisturizers for me, even if they don't always work by themselves, they are usually something that I can adjust and that I can make them work for me. Again, like adding the Catrice or a concealer and, you know, just kind of playing around with them. This formula was just so inhospitable. Again, didn't work, always thick and cakey, and it's just not something that worked for me. Along with the CC cream, I also did not like their Invisible Blurring Loose Powder, and this one kind of shocked me because there are two reasons I didn't like it. Number one, it is constantly, and I mean constantly, deepening up my under eyes, like to the point where they look so orange and so off kilter from the rest of my face. And there was no way that I could fix it. Like no matter what I did, no matter what concealer, what shade the concealer was, no matter what, this was always darkening up my under eye really, really bad. And so for me in that area, it was definitely a no. From there, obviously I couldn't use it under my eyes. So I tried using it all over my face, just, you know, as like an all over setting powder. And oh my God, this emphasized every single teeny tiny little wrinkle. Let me just tell you, okay, I am a 30-year-old lady and I have a lot of little wrinkles, creaks, and crevasses going on this face. And this powder, oh bitch, it found every single fucking one. And it was not a cute situation. So that is definitely a pass. And from there, the last item from Honest that I have is their eyebrow pencil. Now, this one, I will say up front, I appreciate the fact that even though it is a sharpenable pencil, I really like that they included a spoolie on the end. I thought that that was a nice touch. But for me, the problem with this is by far the consistency. consistency. It is so freaking soft. Like the product itself is just way, like it's overly malleable. When I say soft, I'm talking like I would freshly sharpen this pencil, okay? Like freshly sharpen it. It has a beautiful point. Everything is good to go. But before I was even done with one brow, like I would get the tail done and I would have to resharpen it because it just would not hold any sort of a point. Obviously then at that point, as you move down the sharpened pencil, you know, you get into like this thicker kind of pencil lead. So while you're doing your brows, they end up thicker than a fucking skyscraper. You end up having to make the choice between sharpening your pencil every, I don't know, 6 strokes into your brows, or you can, you know, just have brows that are this thick and call it a day, because ultimately with no precision, you can't control the thickness of the brow. So for me, that's a big old no, because my brows are already a pain in my ass and I don't need anything to make it more complicated. So no, thank you. So next up we have this little guy from Il Makiage. This is their Woke Up Like This Flawless Base Foundation. And this is actually the only item out of everything here that you guys probably had no idea I even picked up or tested. And this was actually supposed to be its own foundation review. And this is the packaging right here. It's actually super beautiful in terms of like the component. It has a really nice weighted glass bottle, frosted glass bottle, very nice, very luxe feel. But the reason that you never ended up seeing this on any video or even applied at all was because this foundation, the very first time that I wore it, it was absolutely awful. Like I'm talking 2 hours in, my skin was literally so itchy and so like, this is all I can think to do because oh my God, the feeling of this on my face, it's like, it's almost like it repelled away from my skin and kind of floated on top of it and like moved around. It was super sluffy. Like, I'm talking movement to the point where after just those couple of hours, I had to completely remove my full face because I was able to take just my finger and wipe it across my nose, like my cheek area right here. And all of the foundation came off because it was so broken and so nasty. Did try to wear this one or two other times after that experience just to see if it was a fluke. I tried a different primer and, you know, just tried to work with it a little bit more. But this is just a foundation that for whatever reason, it fights my skin, it makes me itch, and I really, really don't like it. And just as a side note, something I thought was funny, on the back it says that this creates a flawless natural matte finish. Nope, not on Big Mama's face it didn't, okay? Not even by a little bit, okay? Not even a freckle bit did that happen. But then it also says that you get a super comfortable weightless feeling. In what world? No, bitch. No, 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 bitch, no. Moving on from there, we're gonna talk about two items from Revolution Beauty, Revolution Pro, Makeup Revolution, whatever you wanna call them. And that would be their Overload and their Indulgence palettes, which I was so excited to try these. I think I used them in like a full face, maybe testing new makeup, drugstore, something like that. I'll link it up here. Just for reference, this one is the Indulgence palette and this one is the Overload palette. And in terms of, you know, the packaging and all of that, like I said, I was super excited. I thought they looked stunning. But as soon as I got them, I started playing around, testing like the quality, the consistency. These are nothing but a greasy, nasty mess, okay? They do not look good on your skin. They don't apply well. And honestly, that is the biggest issue with both of these palettes. Like, I don't need to sit here and go through every single one and be like super nitty gritty because no matter what you're looking at inside of these palettes, I want you to just look at the color, even if it looks beautiful, okay? I just want you to look at it and go, ooh. And then I want you to immediately envision that you took that and just smeared it on like motor oil on your cheek because that is how it looks. That is how it repels. And honestly, for me, the formula of these is the worst because again, I don't want to put anything on my cheek that has that texture, that consistency, that repelling factor. And then to add insult to injury, you make the packaging so beautiful, you make them so attractive, and it just doesn't work, okay? It doesn't work with anything. I don't recommend them. And truly, truly so disappointing. I can't even tell you, okay? I can't even tell you how disappointed I am. All right, so moving on to the next product here, I have from NARS their All Day Luminous Weightless Foundation. And bitch, this looks so bad on my skin. I think I first tested this in, I wanna say like testing Bergdorf Goodman sale items or something. I'll go ahead and link the video up here. And I think I can sum this up in two ways very quickly. The first side, if you wear it by itself, you know, just like you would any other foundation, it settles into every single pore, wrinkle, crack, crevasse, every single situation. Bitch, it just settles in and makes a home and lives there and looks absolutely disgusting by itself. Then to the flip side of that, when I tried to mix it, whether again it was with foundation, concealer, powders, whatever, like no matter what combo I used with this, it looked so thick and so cakey and just so nasty on my skin. And honestly, there's just no way to wear this and have it look good. I'm convinced of it at this point. I've tried mixing this in so many different ways that you would think at this point at least one of them would work. But again, it's either settling into everything on its own or looking thick and cakey. And neither of those are particularly things that I'm looking for in a foundation. So that is a big ol' no for me. All right, now moving on to an item from Pixi. Okay, this is their Natural Brow Duo. And guys, I hate this, okay? It's a pencil gel gel combo. And of the two sides, this one right here is the pencil. In terms of the actual quality of it, it just doesn't have a lot of payoff. It's very, very stiff, both in terms of the pigment and in the usage of it. So it does kind of scrape your brows quite a bit. And for me, it's just not something that I gravitate towards. Again, that texture just doesn't work for me. The gel on this is it is absolutely awful. This is it right here. I know you can't really see it on camera, but it is the weirdest light watered down milky brown kind of color. And this, like, by the way, this is the shade Deep Brunette, okay? Like, it should have some kind of pigment to it, but oh my god, it is literally, there's nothing to it. But let me just show you, okay? I am wiggling this wand all over my hand. Do you see any color in here? Literally zero, okay? This is no tint brow gel. Don't get me wrong, okay? I can get past like a clear brow gel. They're not my favorite, but like I wouldn't be mad if that's what this was, but it is very clear based on the color of this right here that that is not what this is supposed to be. It is supposed to have some kind of tint to it. And again, literally zero tint happening, okay? Zero. And then just to add insult to injury, the gel itself, like as a brow gel to hold your brows in place, bitch, it don't do that. It don't do nothing. It's useless. Don't get it. You don't need it. Now moving on to the next product here. This is from Kiko Milano. This is their 3-in-1 Tuscan Sunshine Mascara. And it's supposed to be one of those dual-ended situations where one end has volume, one end has lengthening. You pair them up and you're supposed to have these great lashes, right? Absolutely not. No, thank you. And I'm just going to be straight blunt about this, okay? This mascara did literally nothing for my lashes. The fact that this has two ends and ultimately two chances to work really well, and I can't get anything out of any of them, whether I combine them, put them separate, whatever. It does kind of make me hate it just a little bit more, so I definitely don't think you need this. All right, so at this point, I have two items from Benefit to talk about. Now, they were both sent to me in PR, just putting that out there. Obviously, the fact that they were sent in PR has no bearing on what I think of them because I'm talking about them right now. First item that I have to talk about, I do think I've mentioned before, and that is their Hello Happy Air Stick Foundation. And you guys, this foundation looks so bad on me. Just to give you guys the bullet points, because again, I do think I've mentioned this before, so I don't want to like spend too much time on it, but this foundation, it never really like presses into my skin. It always tends to want to sit on the surface of my skin. It looks very heavy, very thick, very, very makeup-y is the only way that I can think to describe it. So ultimately what I was left with anytime I used this was just a big, thick, bulky layer of foundation that really didn't provide much coverage and didn't really do much to even enhance like the look of my skin, at least not in a good way. So for me, this was definitely a pass. And then the other item from Benefit I don't think I've talked about before, and that would be their newer Georgia blush. And this is supposed to be more of like a golden peachy kind of shade, but for me, I mean, like, if I'm being honest, you guys know I'm just like a big old blush fiend, and this blush delivers almost no payoff. Like, I don't even know if you can see it. I just did like a pretty big swatch of it in the middle of my hand right there. For me, the same reason that I don't like this blush is the same kind of reasons that I don't really like that foundation, because when I go to, you know, go in and just use this as my blush, I have to build it up so much just to get any real color out of it, like any real pigmentation, that it looks like in the end, because it has kind of a sheen built in, it ends up, I get the color, but then it looks really heavy and really kind of thick and very texture emphasizing on my cheek. Don't think that this is a blush you need. I feel like there are so many other better options on the market, whether you're looking drugstore or high end. And for me, this one just did not work at all. All right, so the last three products that I have are all from Tarte. And this, we're gonna start off with one of my least favorite, and that would be their Maracuja Tinted Hydrator. And you guys, this is one of the worst, like right up there with that Honest Beauty CC cream. This is so bad on my skin. A lot of the same reasons actually as the Honest one. It looks very thick, very heavy. It does not work well with other products at all. I will say though, it did mix a little bit better with my Catrice than the Honest one did, because obviously I tried it with that as well. And when I did mix it with the Catrice, again, I was able to get a little bit more use out of it that way. And ultimately for me with this product, and also as well as the other two that I'm going to talk about, this is one of those things where I felt like I was putting in so much work and so much effort to get a no effort kind of look. And to me, like, that's the mark that you're not working out. So this is definitely not something I think you need. Again, stick with the ColourPop one. It is amazing. I'll make sure it's linked down below. It is so, so good. So this is a no for me. Then along the same lines as that tinted moisturizer, I have the Tarte Hydro Sealer. And you guys, this product makes me violent because it is so freaking useless as a concealer. And I'm not talking just because like, oh, it has light coverage, blah, blah, blah. No, okay? This is useless because it literally blends out to nothing. Like, I'm not talking a light concealer. I'm not talking light coverage, okay? I am talking absolutely zero coverage. Like, it is undetectable on the skin, because as soon as you go in and you blend it in, or like, you know, blend it in with a blender, a sponge, whatever, it just dissipates. Like, it's such a high volume. Where did it go? And the only thing that I can think with this is that it must be like 95% water, okay? Because it does nothing, okay? It won't stay on the surface of your skin. It won't give you any coverage. And no matter where, how, why I try to use it, it's awful. And I don't recommend it. I don't think that anybody needs this. Like, I'm talking, don't even bother. If you want light coverage, just buy a decent medium coverage concealer and use less of it and call it a day. But this is just like a waste on so many levels, because I'm telling you, no matter how much you build it up, it looks like shit and it's not worth it and you don't need it. All right, so now moving on from there, the last product kind of sums up both of those other products as well. And that would be the Tarte Surfer Curl Mascara. And this mascara is so frustrating, because no matter how much you build it up, there is like no good like black oof to your lashes. Like, they don't even have like that good like level of coatedness to them. Like, forget the fact that it doesn't curl, doesn't lift, doesn't do shit for them, but it doesn't even give me like that nice satisfying like, oh yeah, like I can at least see it on there. Like, bitch, no. Like, it's so watery and so thin in consistency that it doesn't build on your lashes. You can't get any volume. You sure as hell can't get any surfer curl, whatever the hell that is. And I just, like, this mascara, it was so disappointing. I actually, you know what? I think I probably didn't like this one even more than I didn't like the Kiko Milano one. And that's saying something, because that one just really did kind of piss me off. But this one made me mad, because I at least expected to get something out of it. And I literally couldn't get like one good thing from it. So I just, like, no, it's like, it's a no. It's just a no. But all right, you guys, that is it. That's the end of the video. Definitely be sure to let me know all of your thoughts and opinions down below, whether it is on the makeup, the products, if you've tried them, if you also hate them, or even just other makeup that you guys have tried lately that you also don't like. Feel free to spout off down below. And of course, as I said at the start of the video, please feel free to subscribe, turn on your post notifications, follow me on Instagram. That one's very important. You guys, that is it. Thank you all so much for watching. Please don't forget to have an amazing day, night, weekend, whatever it is when you're watching this, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye. Oh, that's better. That's so much better. Okay. I don't know why that equates to better, but it does. Okay. Bring it to you. You get the bucket and you bring it to you. It's not a bucket, it's a box. Mm. Shut up. Well, hello, beautiful people. Welcome back. So for today's video, we are going to be talking about makeup. That was a weird little, did you hear that in there? Today's video. Calm down. So for today's video, we are going to be talking about makeup fails. Makeup fails, makeup fails, makeup fails. Why did I repeat that? We are doing one of everyone's favorites, makeup fails. Okay.